I've put together a simple circuit here consisting of just two resistors. Both of these resistors are 1 kilo-ohm resistors. The first resistor represents the source impedance and the other resistor represents the load. We're going to use the function generator to send a sine wave into the circuit, and then we're going to use the oscilloscope in order to take a look at the waveform that comes out. We'll be using channel 1 of the oscilloscope to see what the function generator is giving us. I can confirm a 1 volt peak-to-peak signal entering this circuit. Let's use channel 2 to take a look at the signal across the load resistor. We're seeing a 0.5 volt signal across the load resistor. Of course, the voltage is going to decrease because we've set up a voltage divider. Let's see what happens when we substitute that 1 kilo-ohm load resistor with a 10 kilo-ohm load resistor. The peak-to-peak voltage is now 0.94 volts. Let's see what happens when we reduce the load resistance down to 390 ohms. The output peak-to-peak voltage is now 0.3 volts. What we can conclude from this demonstration is that the peak-to-peak output voltage depends on the load resistance. That's obvious from the circuit analysis, but it's a perfect situation in which we can use a voltage amplifier. I'm now going to rebuild the circuit, but I'm going to insert the LM741 op amp between the source and the load resistors. What we hope to achieve is a constant peak-to-peak output amplitude even when we change the load resistance. Let's see if we can make it work. I'm going to start off with the non-inverting op amp configuration. I've put the LM741 op amp into the breadboard. We're going to have to use the DC power supply in order to provide the external power. This is a dual channel DC power supply, and just like in the previous video, as I showed with the 9-volt batteries, we're going to have to wire these two channels in series with one another, and the center point is going to be the ground. You can see that I've used a wire to connect the positive pin of one channel to the negative pin of the other channel, analogous to the situation I showed before with the two 9-volt batteries. We thus have both minus VCC plus VCC and the ground point for the circuit. We're starting out with both of the resistors around the amplifier at 1 kilo-ohms. This should give us a nominal gain of 2. I'm keeping the 1 kilo-ohm source resistance and the 1 kilo-ohm load resistance. Let's see what the gain actually is. I'm first going to have to turn on my power supply. Let's give the op amp plus and minus 9 volts. I can confirm that we still have a 1 volt peak-to-peak signal at the input side. Let's use channel 2 to see what it looks like at the output side. With 1 kilo-ohm resistors, I can confirm that the output voltage is about 2 volts. This shows that we indeed have a voltage gain of 2. Let's change the output load resistor. Let's change it to 10 kilo-ohms and we'll see how the peak-to-peak voltage changes. I can confirm that we still have a 2 volt peak-to-peak signal at the load. That's the power of using an amplifier. Our load voltage is no longer dependent on the size of the load resistance. Let's try it with the 390 ohm resistor. We can confirm that with the 390 ohm resistor, we still have a 2 volt peak-to-peak signal at the load. We're going to have problems, though, if I continue to use a smaller and smaller resistor at the load. The reason is because as the load resistance gets smaller, the amount of power that the amplifier has to deliver to that load goes up if it's to maintain the same voltage. If the voltage is the same, then the current is going to increase when the resistor gets smaller. Let me show you that eventually this amplifier is going to run into trouble. Let's now use a 10-ohm load resistor. The output peak-to-peak voltage is now only 0.6 volts, and we can also see that the output waveform is no longer a faithful representation of the input waveform. The amplifier is having trouble, and the reason it's having trouble is because it cannot supply enough power to drive this particular load. So the LM741 is a very good amplifier, but it does indeed have its limits. Let's tear the circuit apart and try the inverting configuration. I'm starting off with both of the amplifier resistors at 1 kilo ohm. The nominal gain of this circuit is thus -1 because I'm in the inverting configuration. We can confirm here on the oscilloscope display that we have 1 volt across channel 1, the input, and we also have 1 volt across channel 2, the output. If I change the load resistor to 10 kilo ohms, we're going to notice that the gain is unaltered. Let me pull out that 1 kilo ohm resistor and replace it with a 10 kilo ohm resistor. We can confirm that the voltages are the same. Let's try the 390 ohm resistor. Again, I can confirm that these two voltages are the same. Let's now try the 10 ohm load. And again, this amplifier is having trouble. The reason it's having trouble with the 10 ohm load is because the amplifier can't supply sufficient current in order to maintain the 1 volt output voltage. What we've learned from these demonstrations is that one of the uses of voltage amplifiers is to maintain a relatively constant output voltage even when the load is changing or even when the source impedance might not be constant. We can control the output voltage, make it fairly constant, and give us a bit more flexibility when we're designing circuits.